Uroš Čirković and Ratko Mladic had almost identical lives. Both were Yugoslav officers, and when the war started in their native Bosnia, they joined the Serb side. 22 years after the conflict, retired Colonel Čirković watches the sentencing of his friend and former commander. Ultranationalist leader Vojislav Šešelj, himself tried in The Hague but acquitted, is a commentator on one of the TV channels. On hearing the sentence of life in prison, Čirković shows no emotion. He says his former commander's punishment is undeserved. But when I ask if he thinks Mladic is guilty of any crimes, he's more guarded.
Maybe, I say maybe. There may be some guilt, but knowing him as officer and man, he is not guilty.
Many Serbs are critical of the tribunal, and the life sentence was not a surprise.
This is the biggest tragedy in the history of justice.
At the Madhouse Cafe, portraits of Serbs accused of war crimes, including Mladic, are hung on the walls. This used to be a nationalist hotbed, but today there are very few customers.
Critics of the tribunal warn that in Serbia, trials for war crimes have neither produced the expected results nor brought reconciliation. Those convicted and sentenced are often seen as national heroes or victims. In this mural, Mladic's political boss, Radovan Karadžić, sentenced to 40 years, is portrayed as a chivalrous martyr.
Those attitudes are deeply embedded, and the change can only come from the top, says this professor of law.
Before the political class and political elite change their attitudes and their values, it is not reasonable to expect the population to cope with the reality.
In an unusually muted reaction, the Serbian president admitted that his nation bears some responsibility, but then sought to shift it.
We are capable of accepting our responsibility, but we fear that all others aren't, and that isn't our weakness. It is rather our strength.
In Serbia, football fans like these queuing up for tickets for a partisan game are usually hardline nationalists. But even some of them want change, admitting that the burden of war crimes is not easy to live with.
It all affects the mentality of the people, the way that they think today. Everyone feels the consequences of those wars of the 1990s.
Despite the students' hopes and the president's statements, many Serbs don't show remorse for actions in the past. And the jailing of Mladic is unlikely to change that. Zoran Kusovac, TRT World, Belgrade.